Advent blessings and peace upon you, my friends. Thank you for joining me and the team in prayer. I'm Father Ron, and this is the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 71, Taking Refuge. In you, Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue and deliver me. Listen to me and save me.
Be my rock of refuge, my stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and fortress.
My God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evil and violent. You are my hope, Lord, my trust, God from my youth.
On you I have depended since birth. From my mother's womb, you are my strength. My hope in you never wavers.
I have become a warning to many, but you are my strong refuge. My mouth shall be filled with your praise, shall sing your glory every day.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 21, verse 28. Jesus said, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' And the son said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards he changed his mind and he went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. And that son said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There's no question that the season of Advent, at least to me, can be summed up in one word. Yes. Yes. A word that always strikes a chord of affirmation and acceptance, you know, no matter how it's used. Well, this season of Advent, friends, and it reminds us of the one person which made it all happen, Mary. You know, an innocent, impressionable, poor young girl who opened her entire life to God and said that one powerful, beautiful word, yes. Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Wow. And despite the struggle and the pain and the heartbreak that yes would have in her life, she never wavered from that affirmation and trust in God. What an example. What a model she is for us, for me in my own life. I mean, her yes put a face on God for us. Well, friends, in our gospel today from Matthew, we have two other examples of people who said yes, the word of our Advent season. One, the first son, struggled and paused, but ultimately lived through that affirmation, surrendering his own concerns, as Mary did, to the will of his father. But the other yes from the other son, well, that was just as loudly proclaimed as the others, but in fact was quite hollow and empty of meaning. A yes that sounded good, but brought sadness and disappointment to the father because it made no difference in his life. Well, friends, I know just because you're praying with us today here at the God Minute that you too have said yes to the Lord in your life. Like Mary herself, in your heart, I know, is also that desire to let your will be done in me, Lord. But I guess the question today is, how are you living that yes? I mean, really, powerfully and boldly, or do we pause like that first son, or do we just not follow through at all like the second? I have to admit, when I look at my life, I recognize all three of the yeses of Advent. The Mary one, the commanding, absolute one, that would be my vocation. Yes, Lord, and I give you my whole life. But in my day-to-day living, that yes, I have to admit, I struggle a lot with following through on it. Like our servants today, our sons in the gospel, my desire to live as my God asks, it's certainly there. But the practice sometimes, well, oftentimes, I have to admit, doesn't always follow through. I live that yes more for me than for God. But I'm also reminded of those great words of Mother Teresa when she says, what the Lord asks from us is not perfection, only fidelity. That desire to live our life for him in the model of our Blessed Mother. I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet. But friends, I'm on the road. I'm on the road, which again is all that Jesus asks. And it's what this season of Advent is all about, getting back on the road of desire. Well, friends, thank you for being on that road with me in support and prayer. Thank you. It's a beautiful thing. And together, in the words of Jesus,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, I want to consciously worship you all day. Then every good thing I'd see as a gift from your heart, and every bad thing as a test from your hand. Please give me a moment-by-moment God-centeredness, that everything I do and say may be yes to you and only you. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you so much for praying with us. What a blessing this is. I hope your day is filled with beauty and joy. And don't forget to say yes to God and thanks. We'll see you tomorrow.